How easy is it to dig up your personal information online? Here's a true story for you. Last month, a friend of mine asked me for a special favor. She'd met a guy through an online dating site, we'll call him Dreamy Drew, and wanted to learn more about this guy before she got too emotionally involved. He was being a bit coy, so that's where I came in. All my friend could give me about this guy was a blurry profile picture, a first name, and some random about me stuff that he'd probably made up on his dating profile page. But within 20 minutes, I knew everything about Drew, down to his home address, his phone number, and some juicy details that would end up telling my friend all she needed to know to move forward. So how did I do it? And what would you have done? My hope is that as you watch me unmask this guy who thought he was being completely anonymous, you'll learn a bit about the most common mistakes people make when they try to hide online. Welcome to All Things Secured. My name's Josh, and you need to know that the photos, the names, and the identities of the people involved in this story have been completely changed for their own privacy and protection. My goal here is to educate us. I'm not trying to embarrass or harm anybody. That kind of malicious search and publication of private identifiable information is what's known as doxxing. And not only is it illegal in many countries, it's also not cool. I mean, it's a form of cyberbullying that it's at least helpful to understand so that you can take steps to protect yourself. And if you stick around to the end of this video, I will share with you a few of those important steps that you can take right now. So back to Dreamy Drew. I decided to start with his profile photo, which was a very pixelated, like, side profile picture. I mean, I could make a guess based on the photo that he was a middle-aged white guy, assuming, of course, that he had used a real photo of himself, which is never a guarantee. I decided to try two things. First, I looked at the source code of the webpage to inspect the profile photo. It was a long shot, but I was checking to see if the photo had accidentally been labeled or if the title of the image was his actual name. It wasn't. Okay, so next I downloaded a copy of the photo and did a reverse image search on Google. I did this because some of us tend to use the same profile picture for all of our social media accounts. I wanted to see if I could match this photo to a photo on a public Facebook, Instagram, or LinkedIn account. All I had to do was to go to Google image search, upload the image, and then see what results came up. Now, I had to sift through a lot of results, but ultimately, I never found a match. Evidently, Dreamy Drew had never used this photo anywhere else, or at least nowhere that had been indexed by Google. Okay, so the profile picture was looking to be a dead end. I tried doing LinkedIn and Facebook searches based on a few scant pieces of information he provided when describing himself, but the search was just really too broad and ultimately yielded nothing. And then it happened. While searching through the source code on his profile page, I found a tiny piece of information that may seem insignificant, but it proved to be Dreamy Drew's Achilles heel. It was his username. Now, while his public profile had been given a random number as an identifier, the dating website had failed to remove his username from the website code. Now, keep in mind, I'm not hacking or doing anything illegal here. I'm simply reading the publicly available code that you can see by clicking developer tools in your internet browser and then finding the source code. And just like profile pictures, people also tend to reuse the same username on multiple online accounts. Now, it wasn't his name, it was just a random username, but sure enough, when I added that username to the end of Instagram and Facebook, there he was, Dreamy Drew in all of his glory. I learned a lot about Drew from his public Instagram account. It was a treasure trove of information, including his evening drinking habits, his previous girlfriends, and what looked to be cute little Drew Jr. Now, I'm reserving any kind of judgment here, I promise, but little Jr. was not listed on the dating profile, that is for sure. Out of sheer curiosity, and because sometimes, as my wife would tell you, I simply don't know when to stop, I decided to learn whatever else I could about Drew and Drew Jr. Now that I knew his full name and general location, I was able to do a reverse lookup on an online white pages. Remember that old printed book that used to be delivered many decades ago with the names, addresses, and phone numbers of everybody in that particular city? Well, those exist online now. They cover more than just one city, and there are tons of them. Whitepages.com, Spokio.com, publicrecords.com, and many others. And you know what's scary? With a simple search, I was able to get Drew's age, his phone number, and what looked to be his home address. But come on, I mean, how did I know for sure that that was his actual address? Well, again, because I simply don't know when to stop, I did a public record search for the address, searching through tax records and publicly available property documents. And what I found was the cherry on top of this whole search. The house that Drew and Drew Jr. lived in was listed under a woman's name who just happened to be the same woman Drew had posted a picture of on his Instagram account for Mother's Day. Yep. Although I can't say with 100% certainty, I can make an educated guess that Drew still lived with his mom. All right, so we just went from anonymous profile to Google Street View of the front door of his mother's house in less than 20 minutes, found legally using publicly available information. If that doesn't scare you, I don't know what will. Again, I'm not trying to discriminate against single parents or people who live with their parents, but part of that information, particularly having a kid, seems like something that needs to be shared on a dating profile. And I was glad to be able to provide that information to my friend before she got too emotionally invested in that relationship. So what can we learn from Dreamy Drew's story? Well, first of all, and this is the easiest thing you can do, honestly, is to make your social media accounts private. Unless you're trying to build a public personal brand, there's no good reason you should have a public account. Making Instagram private is a simple switch on your privacy settings that you can see right here. Facebook is slightly more complicated, but I've walked through the process in this video if you want to look at that when you're done here. The second thing you need to understand is that regardless of your own privacy habits, you have a ton of your old information that is circulating around the internet. It doesn't even matter if you don't have a Facebook account or if you rarely get online. At some point, there was some court record, property record, or other document that was sold to a data aggregator and is now available for sale online. You can manually go through and find all of these data dumps from places like White Pages that I mentioned earlier, and you can submit a request to remove your profile information. I'll link to a DIY guide for how to do that for free in the description of this video. Just know that it is time consuming and that based on my experience, it can be a little bit frustrating. Another option here, at least one that I'm currently testing, is using a service like Delete Me to find and scrub all my private information off the internet. Now, I'm gonna do an in-depth review of how this works in my next video, but it saved me hours and hours of time trying to find and remove this information online. So far, I'm happy with the results. Finally, the last lesson I want you to take away from the story here is this. Online anonymity is a myth. That doesn't mean that you should just throw up your hands and give up. The pursuit of privacy is a worthy goal, but a false sense of anonymity has a tendency to make us relax, to let down our guard and perhaps say or do something that might come back to bite us later. We want to be prepared, not paranoid. So to that end, the next thing you need to do is you need to watch this video here where I walk step by step through the process of how I erased my address, my phone number, and other private information from the internet. So click here to watch it now.